Yo, welcome back, Headbangers Ball Part 2, and I've now been joined by tonight's very special studio guest, Lenny Wolf of Kingdom Come. Thanks for coming down, Lenny.
Thank you for being here.
Great. Now, you're back with a new album, Hands of Time, which is very much a solo effort, as we're going to be finding out later on. But the obvious question is, what happened to Kingdom Come as a band? Why did you split back in 89?
To make a long story long now. But actually, the main reason for Kingdom Come's breakup was James and I. James was very unhappy for a period of like 6-7 weeks. I was always trying to find out what it is, what was bothering him, why he was so unhappy, but he was unable to tell me or give me any reasons. So after a while, the whole thing turned into bad energy, negative vibes and stuff, and we didn't want to go on like that. So we decided to go separate ways, which I think worked out for the best for him and me. In fact, I just saw him again a couple of weeks ago in LA, and he seems to be very happy. Mm-hmm. I think he's going to join the Michael Schenker group, so it's going to be good for him. And I want to say that this is not a Don Dawkins syndrome. We don't hate each other. None of this like he's an idiot and blah blah. I mean, I still care for him very much. We spent 3.5 wonderful years together, and you never know what happens in the near future. Yeah? But it had to happen. That's what it is.
Right. And the fact that you've kept the name Kingdom Come rather than going under your own solo name suggests that you're continuing with your original concept for the band and its music.
I had a dream 4 years ago. It was called Kingdom Come. I wrote the first record before I ever put the band together, right? So I wanted to put a new band together before I go in the studio. I was looking for musicians, I was playing with several musicians, very good musicians. The problem is that most of them, although they were very good, they were all very limited in their style. And I wanted to do a very versatile record, a different record in itself. That's why I ended up hiring different musicians, mostly concerned about making a great record and then worry about this band image. And speaking of band image, I mean, if you look at bands like Whitesnake, it's all cover deal. Rainbow, it's all Richie Blackmore. Bon Jovi is Bon Jovi. I mean, it's not a secret. Mm-hmm. I guess I happen to be one of the few to admit it's not gonna be a band. Mm-hmm. Although I must say I would like to kick butt again with the family, you know. If I meet the right match one of these days, I'll be the first one to say, hey, great, let's do it together, but I haven't yet.
Right, and Hands of Time is very, very much a solo effort, because not only did you write the songs and obviously sing vocals, you produced as well as lots of other input, didn't you? Could you tell us?
The reason why I wanted to produce this record is simply to be able to really make a very personal statement. I'm one of those guys who have a very clear vision about how they want to do what, or at least how they don't want to do something, right? And especially after the band breaking up and all the press we had to live up to or live with, right? All those like duck and hide tomatoes coming left and right. I had to show my remaining fans, or hopefully lots of new fans, I don't know, what Lenny's really all about. This is a very personal statement, especially lyrically. Songs like Should I Talk About What I Went Through the Last 2 Years, Hands of Time, Blood on the Land, statements about the environment or having to compromise to make it work. So I was trying very hard to stay away from this cliche stuff a little bit and orchestrate my record from a different point of view, which I think I did. I'm happy with it, so hopefully it's up to you to decide whether it sucks or not, but I'm sure I'm going to find out soon, right?
And you also played some instruments on the album as well, didn't
yeah,
you?
I love playing bass, and I really got down to it this time, especially writing bass licks, not just hammering half an hour, so I was trying to. Once again, I was trying to do something more different.
Yeah. But being so close to the project, you just said how personal it was. How could you remain objective? How could you say this is good, this is maybe not so good throughout the recording?
I've been taught a lot. I mean, people surrounding me telling me, Lenny, you should be doing this. This is what the press expects. You should not sound like this again, blah, blah. And I said, listen, guys, I just simply allowed myself to be myself.
Right.
That's all it is. When I write songs, I don't think about anything in particular. It's a very innocent, pure business writing songs, and it's a very spontaneous business. I just write the way I feel. And on the other hand, especially knowing that I am in control producing this record, I was still very curious and open-minded in terms of critics, like people coming and telling me what the thing. So I recorded the record in Holland, Whistlelot Studios, and had all the secretaries coming and say, listen, what do you think about this keyboard part or this particular solo? Should it be less aggressive, more, you know? So it was kind of a, like Holland production, if you want to put it this way, you know? So.
Okay, well, it's time for you guys out there in Europe to make up your own minds, because we're going to see the European premiere of the debut video. Could you get us into it, Lenny?
All right. Here it is. Should I? first video, first single of the new record Hands of Time, coming up now. I hope you enjoy.
Well, what an unusual video, a million miles away from the imagery of Do You Like It, the kind of traditional heavy metal imagery. Yeah. Could you tell us a little bit about it?
About the video?
Yeah.
I'm going into space, all these candles around here and stuff. once again, I was trying to stay away a little bit from this cliche stuff. You know, the lonely guy standing on top of a mountain, being heartbroken, doing the Jack Daniels number, doing the live performance. I mean, it's good, but I mean, since there isn't a band, I was just trying to express what I felt visually, since there is MTV after all, you know, trying to make it work. And that's basically all it is. I mean, trying to do something different, and what I felt, what I saw myself going through, put it on tape visually for MTV. That's all I did. There's no deep message behind it or any master plan, no secrets. It's just the new video.
And is the song itself in any way related to your, how you felt when the band split up?
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. I mean, the whole record is a very personal statement. Mm-hmm. It's 110% Lenny Wolf, and I think people who really deal with the record really get to know me very, very much. I mean, all the songs more or less talk about how I felt about certain situations.
And for me, one of the outstanding features of the album was that your very, very powerful, strong vocals. Was that was that just kind of maturity on your part?
Or oh,
was
yes. I've been growing a lot. It might have to do with me having moved back to Germany, refocusing, spending time with friends and family, walking the streets I grew up in, after having lived in Los Angeles for 8 years, which is fun, but it's a kindergarten, a lot of money. And having went back to Germany really like made me see things a little different. Having digested all the last, I mean, all the tomatoes on good or bad press, I mean, all the information, you know, it's let it sing for a while, focus, rethink, write songs, and it's a growing process, you know.
And did you use a different technique in the studio for your vocals?
A very different technique. I was always wondering how come my demos feel so much more relaxed. I'm not talking about the production, I'm talking about the feel, right? Something felt better about it, so I was trying to remember, what did I do? I did remember, I was singing my demos in my living room. So what I did is in the studio, I brought in two living room lamps, you know, with shades, like very old fashioned, lit the candle, sent them out the room. I was running the console myself. I was sitting just like I'm sitting now with legs up. And this is how I sang the chorus for Should I? I mean, most of the songs. Because when you stand in the recording room with the red light on, and now, Lenny, you gotta be great.
Yeah.
You have a tendency to stiff up, like, oh, okay, I'm great now. So we need to sit there all by yourself. Should I, blah. It's just a much more relaxed atmosphere and feeling.
I really think that came through very much on the record.
Great.
Okay, we're going to be talking some more in just a short while. We've got some more music coming up for you now, and this is a European premiere. It's from Armored Saint. It's from their brand new album, Symbols of Salvation, Rain of Fire. For Getting Heavy with the brand new video from Pantera. And I'm still with tonight's studio guest, Lenny Wolf of Kingdom Come. And talking of heavy, Lenny, most of the album is very, very intense and heavy. But if we highlight one song, You're Not the Only I Know, that kind of adds a bit of levity to it, doesn't it? Could you tell me a little bit about that particular song?
It's actually funny. You're Not the Only is a song I wrote out of a joke. I was writing a song for a record company, quote unquote a commercial. I hate the
dreaded word.
Hot, terrible word. So I grabbed a good old six-string acoustic guitar, sat down, went back to my Beatle roots, and just blah blah along for 45 minutes. That's how long it took to write that song. I presented it to Polygram 2 days before we actually started recording the record, right? Polygram freaked, loved it. I said, okay, I'm gonna record it. Added a couple of dirty guitars to give it some edge, right? Mm-hmm. And it turned out to be a pretty good song. It's very mainstream. I can't say I love it, but I like it. It's different. So once again, it's you guys out there to tell me, you know, what it is, you know?
Great. Now, as you've been saying throughout this interview, this album is very, very personal, and it's kind of bearing your soul, isn't it? Is it going to be very difficult for you to accept any criticism?
No, I can handle criticism, especially after what we went through very well. There's a fine line between tearing a record apart from somebody who doesn't even know what he's talking about and a healthy criticism, you know what I mean? Wanting to be in this business, you have to live with media and criticism and reviews and blah blah blah. I just wish sometimes that I wouldn't have to read those like kind of smart under vibe remarks. It's like my philosophy is, if I don't like something, I don't have to buy it or listen to it. If I think I can do it better, I do it better. I don't just talk about how it could be, you know what I mean? So I trust more on the people out there who actually listen to the music instead of, you know, some rubbish makers.
And as far as the fans are concerned, do you think that you have a lot to prove because you haven't got the chemistry of a band anymore to back you up, and the heavy metal fans really love a band, don't they?
Yeah, this, like I said early on, I mean, this whole band image thing, it's all good if it's really a band. And years ago, I always wanted to be in a band, grow up together, live together, build the house together, you know. But I haven't really found my match yet. A couple times I thought I did. Stone Fury, Kingdom Come. We spent a lot of great years together. It was an emotional roller coaster. But I haven't had the luxury like Paul McCartney and John Lennon to grow up together and conquer the world. There was always some differences, or in the long run things that didn't work out. Mm-hmm. I knew I'm not always the easiest to work with because I got such clear visions.
Right.
So if I find my match, I'd be more than happy to say, hey, let's put the wedding ring on, you know. So not yet.
Great. Okay, well, it's time for us to see some more music right now, and coming up we've got the brand new video from Jane's Addiction, and this is a track called Classic Girl. Okay, I've just got time to ask Lenny one more question, and it's a pretty obvious question. When are you going to get the band together? Are you going to be doing any touring?
Absolutely, I can't wait, especially after having had to cancel our first headline tour throughout Europe. I can't wait to come out here. And I'm in the middle of putting the band together right now as we speak. There are a couple ideas I have, a couple players I feel strongly about, but the band is not complete yet. But it will be complete very soon, and I think we'll be hitting Europe sometime in September. Mm-hmm.
Any old member of the old Kingdom Come lineup?
I can't tell you anything yet.
You can't. All right.
Secret.
Well, thanks very much for joining us, and
thank you.
Please keep us posted on all your activities.
All right.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, before we go into the next break, I've just got time to tell you that.